entering a Jewish cemetery. Near the Turkish border, there is a Muslim cemetery, and in between, there is a Christian cemetery. The people, it is the most favorite burial place for the three monotheistic religions to bury their people on top of Mount of Olives.
Settlement movement and the roads, the bypass roads, and the separation wall, the policy of changing the facts on the ground seemed to be occurring. And so how is a two-state solution going to be possible?
Well, we know these are exactly the problems, the real problems. And Israelis, of course, are always saying these are the wall is temporary. I told them, if temporary, don't build it. And you know, it doesn't look so. The other day they told us this, it doesn't look like this. It's the settlements also are not temporary, and they must end. The odds are all against the two-state solution. But for me as a church and a man who believes in peace, we are committed still to two-state solution. If we speak about one state, we are frightening the Israelis as if we say we want to eliminate your state, and we don't want. Although I can see from what's going on, we will have three prisons, one in the north, one in the south, and one in Gaza. Three big prisons. And in these three prisons, you will not get there civilized people. You will get there others. You will get there more extremism. And for this reason, we are still talking and will continue to speak on the vision of two-state solution. Although the odds are against us. We don't want to frighten the Israelis. Because nor do we want to find the world, because the world is not a two-state solution. But we ask this, when this question which you asked me, I always ask the Israelis, I always ask the politicians, I mean, which two states, where? I believe, but where will the borders be? Exactly, it's exactly the dilemma that is ahead of us. But if Israel is serious in an international conference and will set the boundaries, now, the good news is that you have some voices, although they are very shy, very shy ones, like the Minister of Education, Yuli Tamir, has ordered 1 year ago that the textbooks of the schools will put the West Bank 1967 borders to be the borders of Israel. And the Prime Minister Olmert accepted that. And she got a wave of criticism. Now, for me, that's maybe on the map. But for me, that is more helpful than we think. You are always setting where are the borders. Maybe, but in the Middle East, politics in one day can change.